Let's give it up for Valerie.
Kuzco can be manipulative, so he does tell him, don't shake on it unless you mean it.
And Cusco, of course, lies to Pacha and agrees to his demands, but then makes jokes later, like, you should carry me the whole way. And the conflict is not over. He's merely just changed the subject so that the journey can begin. Okay, so Cusco's preference of conflict is competition. So, for example, Pacha falls off a bridge, he gets stuck in some ropes, and Cusco uses this as an opportunity to leave him behind. Cusco does use passive aggression through most of the film, but it is obvious when he sarcastically asks, yeah, as Pacha is begging him for help. He also uses direct aggression by telling him that he was going to imprison him anyway once they got back to the palace, but this is much better. Cusco's competitive nature comes from his upbringing as the future emperor. According to M. Farouk Radwan, a spoiled child keeps crying until he gets what he wants. When he becomes an adult, he continues to cry, but not in tears. Instead, he blames his friends, environmental factors, and external factors. So, for example, in the beginning of the film, we see Cusco as a baby. He breaks his toy, he cries, and 10 more appear. This continues on until adulthood, that is, until he meets Pacha. Now, both characters come to a compromise in order to get home. Cusco subconsciously saves Pacha from falling off of a cliff. Pacha is grateful that he saved him from the cliff, and they continue on the journey. At this point, both are really just ready to get home, but they do form a friendship along the way. So a collaboration between both ends the conflict. Once they return back to the palace, Cusco sort of decides, well, I guess Pacha's, you know, the hilltop Pacha lives on is not ideal. Giving Pacha what he wants, his village is not destroyed. And Pacha suggests, well, there's a village next to me that's pretty good for your summer home. You could build it there, giving Cusco what he wants. So this conflict ended peacefully, but both parties handled it in an inefficient way. The seven-step approach is an effective way to ensure a win-win conflict resolution. The first three steps require both parties to share and listen. First, define your needs. Understanding what you want from the issue is an effective way to begin before you approach the other party. Share your needs. According to Peter T. Coleman, author of the Handbook Conflict Resolution, sharing involves a casual conversation to establish common ground and understand the other's values in the negotiation process. Listening. Once you've shared your concern, it is important to listen to the other party's needs. And the final four steps require both parties to collaborate on the issue and it agrees that the solutions are fair. So you would generate possible solutions, brainstorming together, preventing defensiveness in the conflict. Evaluate and choose. The collaboration will further support both parties in agreeing with the resolution of the conflict. And the final two steps are implementing the solution according to the agreement and following up and ensuring that there is an effective and long-term solution. So today we have analyzed the conflict in Walt Disney Studios, The Emperor's New Groove, showing Cusco's ineffective conflict resolution techniques, the progression one conflict can take as time goes on, and how to appropriately manage conflict. So because of Pacha's humble and communal upbringing, he understands the inevitability of mutual conflict. But if Cusco had been taught at a young age the appropriate steps of conflict resolution in his secluded, affluent lifestyle, his understanding of conflict may have been different.